Hey guys, Cyndaf here, and welcome to Guns of Icarus Alliance. Now, what is this, you might ask? Well, this is an expansion to Guns of Icarus Online, which is a diesel punk sort of airship combat game. If any of you have played a similar game, I would say Black Wake, which launched recently on Steam. It's similar to that, except you're in an airship rather than on a boat, and there's less of you on the airship. But you actually get a variety of airships to choose from, and a variety of guns rather than just cannons. The choice of either being on a galley or a little sloop. That's what I was thinking of. But anyway, this launched the Alliance expansion. I'll say expansion. It does require the original Guns of Icarus Online to play, but when you buy Alliance, you get a copy of the original anyway, so it's like that. Because what Alliance is it adds a co-op mode to Guns of Icarus, which was just PvP to start with. But yes, this launched on Friday. It's about £15 on Steam. Because I'm in Britain, I use pounds, so get over it. I don't know what that is in other currencies. I think it's about $18, I suppose. Maybe a bit more. But you get a 25% discount if you already own Guns of Icarus Online. That only lasts until the 7th of April. So, what's that? 2 days' time. At least I believe that's when the promotion ends. I'm not entirely sure on the 25% discount, but anyway, getting on with it. It adds a co-op mode, which is what I'm kind of sat in here at the moment. This is the co-op screen. The PvP screen looks kind of like this, but we don't chat going. This is the co-op screen. With the lovely little NPC airships flying past. These are the NPC ones. You can't fly these. They will shoot you though. So you got the main screen. Another new feature of Guns of Icarus Alliance is the faction and the world system. You get a choice of, at the moment, 4 factions to choose from. I shall bring them up here. I've already chosen the Anglian Republic, just because I like the way they look. They are fluffy. But the difference between the factions, other than the way they look, is that they each have their own weapon unlockable as you level up in the faction, and their own ship unlockable. So there's 4 new weapons and 4 new ships to choose from at the moment. There will be another 2 factions being launched relatively soon, for a total of 6, from what I've gleaned out of public chat with the devs. Should be within a month or so. But you have the choice of the Fjord Baronies, who look like this. I'm not going to join them because I will lose reputation with the Anglian Republic for switching factions, and I still haven't unlocked the ship yet. So you have the Order of Shaladon, who have sort of Chinese influences, Japanese influences, East Asian basically. Whereas the Fjord Baronies are obviously kind of French and that area, Europe, that area of old Europe. They're obviously Norsk. And the Mercantile Guild, who are another sort of semi-Asian Silk Road-ish faction. East Indian Empire, I suppose they equate to. But I know of the Mercantile Guild's weapon, unlockable, is a sort of, basically it's a laser. I can't remember what it's called. I don't know what the other two unlock. There is a gas launcher and a multi-missile launcher, it's a swarm missile launcher, but I don't know which one's which. So Anyway, yeah, you can choose a faction. You can swap. You can freely swap between them at a cost of some of your earned reputation with them. And then you get put into the world screen, where you can choose to fight for territory. Each territory has set resources, and each faction is fighting for a certain pair of resources. The Anguilan Republic is fighting for water and lumber, whereas the Fjord Baronies here in the purple are fighting for oil and food. We have in Anguilla we have oil and water, whereas the Fjord Baronies has lumber and food. So each faction will start with another faction's main resource and one of their own, whereas the Order of Shaman over here has medicine and a bit of food and a few mines. They're after mines and food, so they're going to be attacking the Fjord Baronies for their food and the Mercantile Guild for their mines, whereas the Mercantile Guild require water and medicine, so they'll be attacking the Order for their medicine and Anguilla for their water. And it's only the Fjord Baronies that requires oil at the moment, which Anguilla has, but I'm guessing that's going to change when the other factions release. I assume oil's going to be moved, or might be moved down to the desert, or I assume wherever the sixth faction's going to be put. So it's a little awkward at the moment. We have oil over here in the blue, as well as water and see, we've got oil up in the north and there in Hamat, which they've already taken. But anyway, that's that. I can't show you the new ships or weapons because I haven't got them. I do have the new weapon, actually. I have the Febrous weaponized coil there for the Anguilan Republic at level 7. It used to be at level 10 and the ship being level 15, but they lowered it because it's actually takes a long time to get that high in four factions. And I'm getting close to unlocking the Anguilan Corsair. But I can't show you what it looks like because I haven't got it. And the weaponized coil is, well, it's a lightning gun basically. You hold to charge it up and then you release it to arc lightning at a bunch of ships. The longer you charge it, the more damage it does, and the more targets it bounces to. I haven't tried it out in PvE or PvP yet because I only unlocked it yesterday. So, let's jump into a match. We're going to be doing a co-op match, and let's see what we land. I'm going to play as captain because I actually quite enjoy playing as captain. So, let's do that. Okay, here we have our match with four ships. We're doing an assault. This is an assault game mode. And this is my Pyramidian. I've never done a four ship war before, and it looks like we're against the Mercantile Guild. So, let's smash some ships up. Shouldn't be too difficult for four of us, although there is going to be more in the way of enemies. And the boss may be a little harder, and I'm sorry about the inconsistent frame rates, as I have never recorded this before, so I wasn't entirely sure what settings to be using. This is all maxed out, but it looks like the open worldness of it isn't quite getting me the frame rates I need, and I should really shut my dog up. Oh, albatrosses. That's one of the co-op enemies, other than the faction-specific ships that you get to fight against. There's also planes flying around. As you can see, you might have seen that just behind the cruiser. I'm listening to the tar cloud. There, I don't know whether you saw that. Just off the front. Well, there's an albatross. I mean, it's flying to me. But those are bombers. They set everything on fire. They're called out. They're called the albatross. I'd appreciate it if someone actually shot those. Close enough. There's also a couple of other planes. There's a heavy attacker called the Hawk, and a light fighter called the Crow. And if you wonder what I'm up to, is I'm after that. There's a Hawk. I think I just scraped along the side of the spire there, or something. This seems to be going very smoothly. But that's probably because there's four of us. I don't really need to talk to my crew, as they all seem to know what they're doing, so... You only really need to give orders if people aren't actually following you. Alright, Spire, I'll go around the other way. There's a cruiser. Return. Now, the tricks these little ships have up their sleeve, the cruisers and the other faction specific ones, the only other ones I've fought are the Shadowlon specific ones, which are also quite annoying. These ones are the fewer banned ones, I think. You know what? I'm not actually entirely sure. I didn't actually check to see which faction you're fighting. They might actually be mercantile guild ships. Oh, that's a lot of cruisers. Back it up, back it up, back it up, back it up. The cruisers love to get up close and personal. Okay, we just lost two ships. The cruisers love to get up close and personal and ram you, whereas the dreadnoughts have longer range weaponry. But these ones are actually a little easier than the Shadow ships, because they really do like to ram you on with those. The Shadow ones being they're called Axles and Sentinels, for the smaller and bigger ones, respectively. Watch where you're flying, if you don't mind. See what I mean about the cruisers like getting up close and personal? They usually have flamethrowers or something, usually machine guns to take your armor out with, or Gatling guns to go out with. See, that one's got a flamethrower up front. Come down the hill now. Ah, there's a little squadron of crews. The objective underneath me. It must be in a cave. Guys, there's a dreadnought flying in front of us. If you would. Right, let's go and chase that cruiser down, because it's still chasing the junker around. Nice shot. Now I assume the base is going to be down here in the rock. Entirely sure as to where he is. There he is. Pretty sure there was a cave down here. Another guy's died. This is going worse than I thought previously. Getting separated and people are getting chased down and destroyed by the cruisers, because they will chase you down and they will kill you. Here we are, we've got, yeah, there it is, hiding down there. So let's go after the cruisers and save the spire from getting himself killed. The base is also defending themselves, unsurprisingly enough. The boss ship just spawned. Okay. That is for fewer barons. That's a baronite cruiser. Not baronite carrier. So. Not the mercantile guild. Fewer barons. I'll let the jump down here. We will need to kill that spy ship because they give you nice little buffs. First one will give you an engine upgrade, second one will give you a munitions upgrade which increases your damage. Alright, we're under attack here, so never mind the boss, kill the cruiser. Place. I'm loading into that thing. Alright, I'm flying. That's enough, I suppose. Right, well, the boss has started off to defend the final base. Have they not? Really? Take your time and all, but. The supply ship is right there. There we go, that took you long enough, didn't it? I mean, the junker there has guns on both sides, whereas I've only got guns on my left and my front. Don't know why it's taking him so long to kill it, but I believe he's got friends down there, so I'll just go and help him out before he dies again. Since we've already lost half of our deaths. We've got to prevent 8 deaths, so. Cruisers! Oh, he's having trouble. Luckily, they fall pretty quickly, this combo. Melt their armour off with the Gatling gun, kill them with a flat cannon. As long as you get armor shots anyway. Otherwise we've got rocket carousels back there for any passing glances. Right, also I'd like to apologize for the frame rates, all the effects and stuff do seem to tank the old recording frame rate. I do usually get 60 when playing, but it looks like this can't be rendered at 30. Nice shot from the rear engineer there. Doesn't look like we lost anybody just yet. They all seem to be moving as one. And all we have to do is kill the manufacturing place, but don't actually kill the boss. Heads up. Dreadnought. Oh, heads up, Albatross. Bloody thing, set you on fire. Gives the engineer something to do, I suppose. Oh, there's the carrier. The Baronite carrier has the cluster missile launcher. See, there it goes. The engineer's busy putting out the fires. Hopefully someone's actually going after the base, because that would be very useful. I don't think we are going to be able to solo the carrier here, so I'm going to back it up a bit, because they do have flamethrowers on them. I'm pretty sure the Mercantile Guild's is also a carrier, but the Mercantile Guild's one has a gigantic laser on the front, whereas the Order of Shadow one has a giant gas launcher. Looks like they're actually going to the base. I just keep the boss occupied. Although, to the look of it, occupied might be a bit of a stretch. I think they are still on the first stage of the base. Alright, kind of. Oh, that balloon's been popped. Okay, balloon's back. The good thing is, you can't actually die due to weapons fire. Otherwise I would have just, you know, died taking the bomb to the face just then. Yeah, we still haven't even reduced the armor in the manufacturing place. There it goes. Right, that should pop the first layer pretty quick. Should be creamy. There goes the first layer of the boss, with that explosion, and opens up some different weak points. There goes the cruiser. Alright. Any more of our ships died, but they all kind of legged it. That would have been a sensible idea. While we had to sneak in and attack the base here. Unless my rear end is Albatross again. There is a cruiser right there. Back arch. Alright, okay. Yeah, there we go. We got surrounded and killed. Although it was mainly the base defences that did that. I thought more of them were dead than they were. Okay, we've only got one death left. I don't think we're actually going to win this anymore. Our chances were looking pretty strong, but it looks like we may actually lose this. All 8 deaths to the one objective. A good amount of it is these planes flying around are a pain in the ass. Yep, there we go, another death. Fail. there we go. That's just how it goes. Alright, and for our second match, we are doing the same again, but on a normal difficulty. I didn't actually do a vote for map or difficulty, so just whatever was provided. Let's get to it, shall we? Just a quick adjusting of some options. It doesn't seem to have boosted my frame rating, so it's not that. Although, whatever that is flying straight down there, the goldfish, flying straight into a pack of cruisers, which probably isn't smart. But it's on normal, so they have less health and armor. I don't really want to fly into the smog cloud. But anyway, yeah, I'm not really complaining about doing the mission again on normal, because, you know, winning on normal will still give you more XP than losing on hard, so... Even though there's two difficulties after that, there's veteran and hell. Let's stop all the cruisers from running into the backs of these less nimble ships like the Galleon. Then again, this thing isn't particularly nimble. Not like the goldfish. This one's built more for speed than maneuverability. Not speed compared to, say, the squid, but this does have a nice option for ramming people. It's actually reinforced for ramming. Although, whether your ram will work or not is hit and miss sometimes. You just dropped into the ground there, so it's in bed. It's going to hit the mining outpost instead. There that goes. That drops like a fly on normal. The thing I love about this ship, other than the fact that it can ram without taking ridiculous amounts of damage, although there is also an ability that helps with that. Alright, where is that supply ship? That should be just in front of me. There it is. Supply ships aren't really necessary on normal. You'll get by just fine without buffs. But I like to kill them. Oh, if they didn't kill it, I would have rammed it, so... Guns have a nice traverse on this ship as well. Some of the other ships can be a little bit stifling as to turret traverse, especially the Galleon. The Junker's not too great about it either. I'm being hammered by hawks. Damn heavy fighters. Oh, now I'm being hammered by cruisers. I didn't notice those. Nope, he's driving past. Let him drive past. He's going after the goldfish. Shoot that one instead. Perfect. Ah, good. We did actually take care of the hawks there. Alright, well, the second objective is this way, so... Let's fly. Don't know what the old Galleon's doing there. Must be busy with repairs or something. Now, the thing about this is it's really only good at shooting what's in front of it and what's on the left hand side. Oh, goldfish. Goldfish was reversing. I didn't notice him. And that's the problem with being a captain. You can't see what's underneath you. Other than getting someone to tell me if there's something coming up underneath me, I can't actually see myself. I mean, I thought I could have checked the map to see if he was in the area. Which case I could have actually figured out that he might be underneath me. Sometimes it's not always that easy. These things drop like flies on normal. He's under me again. Then the galleon turns up. Okay, we should actually be able to kill this carrier, no problem. Let me get a little bit closer so that we can actually hit the weak points, because otherwise its health is quite high. Well, its damage resistance is quite high. We get the Gatling gun close enough, even with the Lemsoft rounds that it's firing. There we go. Once you get his armor down, it melts. That'll drop no problem, and then we can just storm the base and win. If any, we're doing this well on hard mode. We're all just a little bit after you. We were just all a little bit separated on the previous match, but sometimes it just takes a match or two just to get used to what your teammates do. I mean, I play the pyramid unit. At a reasonable range. Just so that the cruiser doesn't come up to me and mess my day up. That was my fault. Climbed too hard. Trying to get away from him. Firing. Well, that died pretty quick. Must have been the cruiser firing. When things are going well, the main engineer back there who looks after my ship can get on the rocket carousel, help out. I do love the setup. I do also have a setup where one of those rocket carousels is the ferrous lightning coil. I might have to try it out. But I would imagine it's more for sort of the PvP setup. I am lagging. That's not good. Get around the other side. Right, we're flying through that shit storm. see we've got some 4 ping on someone. As your connection's not quite holding up to what it should. It's usually a lot smoother than this when I play on the Americas. We're going to have to back it up because the cruisers are coming after me. And there's one behind me. Okay, backing it up. This little thing does hold up pretty well. I mean, it would hold up less well on some hard mode. I'd have been completely hammered just then, but Engie's doing a very good job of keeping me alive. Which I appreciate endlessly. He's a good shot in the rocket carousel. Get some of that cruiser right there for him. There's just cruisers everywhere, look at them, there's loads of them. No one's died yet, but that might be more due to the difficulty level. Yep, they always go for the ram, although he's manoeuvring this a little out. Okay, I should circle around and hook the base. It's on its last legs, so I can take a hammer and still kill it. As soon as we kill it, we win, so. Damn albatross. Goes. And that's a victory. And there you go, that is Guns of Icarus Alliance. There's a few other game modes as well other than Assault. There's Defense, there's Seek and Destroy, which is almost the same, just looking for targets. What did I say? Defense, Seek and Destroy, Infiltration and Interception. Infiltration is where you have to infiltrate a couple of refineries and then escape without the VIP being blown up. It's the VIP that's doing the infiltration. And Interception is you have to stop the enemy from doing the same, except there's a bunch of ships doing they're running and they have cargo you have to capture. Instead of infiltrating the refineries, they blow them up. So yeah, that's Alliance. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Do feel free to leave me a like if you did enjoy this. Also pick it up and play along. It does need a boost in the old community. Let's back out of here first. It does need a boost in the old community. There's currently 360-370 players online, but it is midweek and sort of, I guess, late morning, early afternoon for the Americas, so as of time of recording. But I've never had any problems in getting into a match, never waited for more than a minute or two to get into a match. Even as a pilot, you're more likely to get into a match if you play as gunner or engineer, obviously, because there's more slots. So, yeah. If you enjoyed, do leave a like, or yeah, you can leave a comment down below and tell me what you think. Tell me if you play, or tell me if you are interested in getting Guns of Icarus Alliance, or if you own Guns of Icarus Online and sort of took a break from it because PvP got a bit stale, which it kind of did, to be honest, because I stopped playing PvP because it got a bit stale. But other than that, the community is really friendly. The devs are really really good. They're always in chat there, as you can see. I'm just going to minimize that. The devs even play the game. There's several of them that play the game during the day. And yeah, other than that, do hit that share button. It would help me out a great deal, and I'd very much appreciate the gesture if you did share it around and things. And you can subscribe for more. And I shall see you all later.